excited to be here. My name is Erin. I'm the owner, founder, and principal artist of Paint Sip Fun. I'm also a 1994 School of Fine Arts grad. Go Huskies. So tonight, as Lauren and Emily just said, we are going to be painting our own Yukon sign. All right. So I am going to show you guys two different ways to do this. One, if you don't have any wood or a wood tray or this is literally just a piece of wood from Home Depot. Okay. It's a 12 by 16 piece, I believe. But if you don't have wood and you only have a canvas, I'm going to show you how to do both. Okay. So I'm going to jump back and forth doing both. This is what it'll look like at the end, regardless of which way you do it. The wood comes out pretty cool. And we're going to need stencils. All right. So I believe when you guys signed up, you got sent an email with the logos, right? Yukon logo and the oak leaf. Okay. So this is what we're going to use to position, trace it, and then paint it. And I'll explain it all later so you don't have to worry about it. If you wanted to customize yours, for example, you can also customize it by writing whatever you want, like your name, if you wanted to put that on there as well, okay? All right, so if you have not had a chance to print those stencils out, it's okay. We're gonna have a break in the middle. So we're gonna paint the background first or stain the wood. Then we have to let it all dry. So during that time, if you need to go print your stencils off of your printer or what have you, you will have time to do that, okay? What do we need to paint? Obviously your stencils, but again, you'll have time to get those ready here in about a half hour, 45 minutes or so-ish. You're gonna need something to paint on, all right? Like I said, I'm gonna paint on canvas and I'm gonna paint on wood as I go. You're going to need palette, something to put your paints on that's slick. Okay, so I have a palette pad of paper that is a palette. You can use a piece of glass. You can use a paper plate, something sort of like that. You're gonna need a napkin. You're gonna need paint brushes. Now, paint brushes, I typically use three, okay? A big one, a medium one, and a little one. It's about this big compared to my hand, okay? So this is a number 10 flat. This is a number 6 rounded point at the top, and then a baby brush that I call, it's a number 1 round, very tiny. This is our details, okay? So you'll need at least 3 brushes for that. And then of course you're gonna need paint. Now, I use 3 colors, black, white, and brown, that's it. So I'm gonna pull out some of my paints, get them ready here, put them on my palette, black, white, and brown. All right. Now you can use any colors really. If you really wanted to do this background blue and stain your wood blue, the dark navy blue that is our colors, you can do that too. That might be a really cool thing to do. But I'm just going to show you the sample, which is done with brown. Okay. So there's my colors, black, white, and brown. I'm going to start literally just with brown. I'm gonna start over here on the wood since I think most of you or the majority of you have wood. Now, wood is really, really, really dry. So you're gonna need a lot of water. Oh, that's the other thing you're gonna need, by the way, a cup of water, all right? I have mine right here, okay? All right, so you're gonna want to make a stain with paint. So grab some water, put it on your palette, just a little whoop, don't drip it on yourself. Grab some paint and you're literally gonna water down, smudge it, smear it, get it all so there's no more chunks in it, okay? Push it out so it's really kind of runny, okay? I tip it, it's really gonna run, all right? That's what you want. And you're going to now stain your wood with this watered down brown paint. I want you to go in the direction, just like if you were to use stain, you're gonna wanna go in the direction of the wood grain, okay? So just keep on mixing, cause you're gonna run out. You're just keep on mixing by adding more water to it. And just keep going up and down throughout the whole thing. Just like we're doing canvases, you're gonna also want to do your sides and the top and the bottom, okay? So as you guys are going You're going to coat the whole thing. Obviously not the back, but the tops, the sides, the front, the bottom. All right, so you guys can take your time doing this. If you want to add your own streaks into it, more wood grain, let's say your wood is pretty plain and doesn't have a lot of grain to it, you can streak wood, streak your paint up and down the wood. Okay, that will also give it that wood grain look. It'll add to it. Trying to move quickly because I don't want to stop anywhere in particular, because you'll see where it stops if you stop like that up there. If I don't catch that fast enough, it will show through in the final product. Just like if you stain, it's the longer you leave the stain on one little section, the more you'll see it later on, if that makes sense. All right, so this is pretty much staining the wood. All right, we're priming the wood, staining it, adding a lot of water. And you can feel free to add more, another layer if you want it a little darker. But just be mindful of if you come up here, and you've got some drips coming, catch them and brush them right out. All right. So that's how you stain or prime and get the background, the wood ready for our next step. Okay, so once this is done, this is our break. All right, we got to let this dry. All right, so I figured I'd show you guys how to get the wood look on a canvas. Okay, so those of you that have a canvas or something else to paint on, could be cardboard, could be whatever, I suppose. Same concept, but without the water. You want it more dry, right? So just more straight paint, right? So here's my really drippy, watery stain that I created. I don't want that. I want straight paint. In the same vein, you're gonna go up and down. Streak it, really long brush strokes. Start at the bottom, end at the top. Try not to start and stop in the middle of the canvas. You'll see the brush strokes of where you start and where you stop. And we want this to look like wood grain. So we want it really, really long from top to bottom. So start your brake paintbrush at the very, very bottom, end it at the very, very top. And it might actually kind of flick at the top, and that's okay. You do want this to be very streaky. That gives it the wood grain look. Really uneven, really a lot of brush strokes, okay? Just keep working it, keep working it. Get all of this brown on the canvas. You can, if you want, add just a little bit of water to your paint to get it to move a little easier. Okay, I just flipped it up here by accident. That's funny. But don't add too much water, okay? Put this out here. Again, the trick to this, really, really, really long brush strokes, okay? After we're done with this component is where I'm gonna show you how to print your stencils to be the right size, because that's what we're gonna need after the break, after this is done drying. Okay. So if you notice, I have some darker areas, some lighter areas. That's what I want, because I want it, again, to emulate wood grain. I don't want it smooth. I want it really streaky, okay? Again, it just gives that effect of a piece of wood. Now, if you've painted with me before or have painted, you know, somewhere else, you'll recall you're gonna also want to paint your edges, top, bottom, and sides. That way, when it's hanging on the wall, it'll look finished and you won't necessarily have to frame it if you don't want to. And again, this is supposed to look like wood, so it'll look like a piece of wood hanging on your wall. Ladder over there by accident. This is also where, if you wanted to add a second coat of brown, you absolutely can. You may not see your streaks as well, rather than leaving it kind of thin like this and letting some of the white sort of show through. But you can, if you wanted to make it darker or match your house. You can even do this, like I said, if you're doing it with blue even, you can streak it in with a couple different shades of blue if you wanted. So definitely when you think you're done, take a good look across, see if there's something in the middle that you may want to fix like that, right? Come back over, make it look like really long grain of wood. If you hear a little puppy in the background, I'm sorry. She just went running like she's gonna bark, so. One of the little, I guess, cons of working from home. Although it's a, I love it. I love it when she interrupts me, but doesn't always make for a great class. So that is how you're gonna get the background of your sign or your canvas, okay? I'll give you guys, I'm gonna give you,
Aaron.
Yeah.
We had a question in the Q&A. Do you have any tips for people that are painting wood trays?
Wood trays. So they've got the edges too and the handles on it. I'm guessing that's what you're saying. Same thing. Go in the direction of the grain. No matter how the grain, she is, sorry. How the grain is, you're going to want to still do the same watered down paint and follow the grain of the wood. It's just gonna take you a little bit longer to kind of get in there and get around and do the handle and the side, right? So just take your time and water down paint. So I hope that there's no real trick to it. You just gotta take your time and go at it. And you might need a smaller brush to get into the smaller areas. So feel free to use more than one brush. Hopefully that answered your question. So I'm gonna give you guys a couple more minutes to get your base coat down on whatever surface. Oh, I see a question came in again. Is painting the background required if we like the plain wood look? No, you don't have to paint the background, absolutely not. You can just do the stencil component, which we're gonna do in a couple of minutes, okay? You're welcome. Hope you guys are listening to some calm music in the background, having a nice drink. The whole concept of this whole industry, just while you guys are painting, this whole industry started down in Louisiana. I don't know how many years ago, maybe 20, 15, somewhere around there. A woman wanted to, she invited several friends over. One was a wine connoisseur and another one was an artist. And she thought, why not do the two together? And thus was born the paint and sip industry. People loved it because those of us that are type A personalities like me, try being an artist and a type A, it's quite interesting in my head, the conversations I have. Sometimes the liquid encouragement helps to stop the chattering voice that we always kind of second guess ourselves, and gets that to quiet down so we can actually enjoy the company we're with. Let's see here. While we wait, let us know in the chat where you're tuning in from. That's a good point. Glastonbury. I'm chiming in from Hamden, Mass, believe it or not. I'm right over the border though. North Carolina, California. Excellent, Amy. I love that idea. Graduation gift. Glastonbury, Farmington. Montville. Nice. Oh, you're coming in from the library. That's awesome. Cambridge. I was just out there. Went out there a couple weeks ago. I think I went to the MFA out in Boston, and then we kind of twirled around over into Cambridge and whatnot too. Let's see here. Delray Beach, Florida. Well, you must be having some nice weather. We had a crazy storm front just run through here. What? A half hour ago? Oh my God. It was like trees were falling down. It was nuts. So all the way down to Florida, Massachusetts, Connecticut, North Carolina, California. That's awesome. We're from coast to coast. Sweet. Stafford Springs, I'm right near you. Like I said, I'm right over the border in Hamden. I go through Stafford Springs when we go for bike rides. Cool. So how are we doing, you guys? Let me know in the chat bar if you need more time. I think the people who have the trays might need a little bit more time. Anybody need more time? Need time. Okay, I had a feeling. Okay, keep going. You can always, if you leave the wood, someone asked if they can leave the background without paint, if they like just the raw wood, that's fine. After you paint it, you can always shellac it or varnish it or polyurethane it later if you wanted to, or you can even just leave it raw. That also gives it a nice kind of a shine to it. But again, it's totally what you like. You can use beeswax also and give it like a waxed finish, sort of, which is a kind of a dull, kind of like a candle wax. The edge of the candle is kind of, it's not major glossy. It's like a matte finish. You can use wax and run over the wood with the wax just to coat it, give it a protective coat sort of too, if you wanted. Again, you don't have to. There's so many ways to finish wood. So this is our break, you guys. While you guys are finishing up painting, there's a couple of you still finishing painting. This is when I want you to make sure that you get your stencils. So I know you guys are all on different sized canvases or different size wood or trays. You're gonna wanna go to like Microsoft Word or Google Docs or something and print out what it is you want to transfer over to your piece, okay? So for example, this is a 16 by 20 canvas. This is an 8.5 by 11 normal printer size paper, okay? So this is the size that I used for the oak leaf on this 16 by 20 canvas, okay? And the same thing with the Yukon words. This is again, a regular standard size piece of printer paper. So it's 11 inches wide. And this is the size that I used for the lettering for Yukon at the bottom, right? If instead you want to use or try to do, let's say your name, you can absolutely do that, okay? Same thing, regular size piece of printer paper, find a font that you like, being sure that you print it as bold, okay? Make sure that these already come out bold, you don't have to worry about it. But this, if you're gonna do something customized, you're going to want to make sure that your font is bolded the way that we have to do it and paint it in. You're going to need area to paint. Okay. If you do a really, really, really thin font, it's going to be hard to get in there and paint that. You can, it's just going to take you a little bit longer. Right. But a couple of things to think about. Find a font that you like. You can even write like the Smiths established 2009, right? When you guys got married, let's say. Or you can write UConn graduate 2021, right? Or like SFA, School of Fine Arts 21, if you wanted to kind of personalize it that way. So the person from California doing this painting, think about that if you wanted to add something underneath it. You can always do it after the class also if we don't have time to, if you don't rush it, okay? But if you do this and do this with us, you'll know exactly how to put in your customized piece at the bottom, you know, graduated 2021 or something like that. Class of 2021, that's even better, okay? All right, so how are we doing on painting, you guys? Are we good? Anybody need more time for paint? You know, not dry, and that's fine. So it's painted and you're done painting, doing the active painting. What you can do to dry it also and quicken the drying time is to go grab a hairdryer. If you want to speed up the process, okay? So mine is pretty much dry, so I'm not going to do this. I'll give it a couple more minutes. I don't want to rush you guys either. So how about at like 6:30, which is 6 minutes from now, I'll come back and do the next step, okay? So make sure you guys have all your stencils, okay? We're going to prepare the stencils here when we get back, and we'll get on from there. The rest of this is all stencil work from here on out, for the most part. I mean, I can last little step of adding the separation between the wood and then the nails, I guess it would be last, but so you can go grab a hair dryer, dry off the canvas if you want to. And then, there's the questions and answers. There's the chat box. Okay. All right, and then we'll get on with it. So go ahead and get your stencils. And this is how we're going to use our stencils. Okay, I'll show you here in a second. Grab your piece of chalk or a standard pencil. I have one. I do, but it's not sharpened. All right. Okay. So while these are drying, let's prep these. It's gonna take me a couple minutes to prep this. So as you can see, it's the same exact lettering, right? I put chalk on the back of the piece of paper, covered it, heavy duty coverage of chalk, which I need to do now. I didn't do it ahead of time. I wanted to do it with you guys. So grab your chalk. If you don't have chalk, you can use graphite of your pencil. And you're basically just gonna cover over, where's my other one? I'm using white chalk at the moment, so you're not gonna be able to see it on camera. But, so this is the one that I did. This is my original stencil that I did for this, okay? I only put chalk on the leaf. I didn't need to put chalk on the white part. I just put the chalk on the leaf part, okay? I used yellow chalk on this one. This one here, I'm gonna use white chalk because I ran out of yellow. Again, just cover over the letter part, where the letter is. It doesn't have to be exact. It can be kind of messy. No, sorry guys. I don't know what she's barking at, but you probably can't really see the white chalk. I only covered over the letters. Okay. I'm gonna do this on this one. Looks like I'm still a little bit wet. I didn't even realize that. Hang on, when I mute you down, I'm gonna dry mine with a hair dryer. All right. I forgot that it was humid out. Usually it's dry by now, but we just had a rainstorm, so it's really wet. If it looks shiny, if you pick it up and move it like this and it has a shine, it looks like water, literally wet, then you need to dry it. That means it is wet. Okay. It's going to have sort of a matte. It should have a more of a matte finish if it's dry. All right. So we have our canvas or our wood. I'll show you the wood here in a second too, but it's the same concept, okay? Stencil with chalk on the back. Now you're gonna take your time, grab a pen, okay? Or a pencil, but I like to use a pen. Try to center your paper where you want it, okay? And this is, you're gonna trace the outer edge of your letters. I'm just gonna do the U at first right now so you guys can see it. Okay, take your time. The more accurate your tracing is, the more accurate and clean lined your finished product will be, okay? So you don't wanna just do this and do one letter, like one line throughout the whole thing. You want to trace. Where are you? There you go. Trace the edges of the letter. Okay. So this is going to give us, now I got to line it up again. This will be fun. This is going to give us where we're going to paint. This is the outline of where we're painting inside the line. So it's kind of like we're creating a coloring book page, sort of, right? With the outlines, and now we're going to paint it in. And that's it. All right. So I'm going to move over. I'm gonna do it on wood because I think a lot of you have wood, all right? So that's how you're gonna do both the oak leaf and the Yukon and also any of your, like the Smiths or whatever your name is or graduated or class of 21 or whatever you're putting to customize it. That's how you transfer it from printer paper to whatever it is you're painting on, all right? You use a piece of chalk on the back. Let me get mine. So. Since my wood is smaller, I went to Home Depot and I got a 12 inch wide wood, really, really long. And I had them cut it down into size. So I had them cut it down to 16 inches. I obviously have to do a slightly smaller stencil, okay? I think I'm gonna do this up here and I might do class of 94, I think is what I might do. I should have thought of that ahead of time and put it all in one paper, but I'll get that in a minute. All right, so. This is a smaller stencil than this. I'm gonna now add chalk to it, all right? And I wanna show you how to outline the leaf. The leaf is a little more detailed and it's gonna take you a lot longer to outline the leaf up on the piece of wood, all right? Oh, I wish I thought of that ahead of time. I'll get it later. Class of 94. Heavy coat of chalk all over where the ink is. And also the trick is keeping your stencil still as you're tracing, okay? You might want to use a piece of tape to hold it down. getting my chalk. Sorry, I know you're seeing the side of my head. Sorry, of my lovely gray hair. Should do it. All right. Now center it up. And like I said, I want to leave a little bit of room at the bottom because I want to write class of 94. Okay. And I'm going to do that obviously with another piece of paper once I print it. Okay. But outlining the oak leaf, you're going to want to outline all of the black. Okay. Or blue, whatever color it ended up printing. This also means the veining inside the oak leaf, you're going to also want to outline that. It's very, 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 very thin. So basically, whatever is white on your paper is going to be the color of the wood or whatever it is that's behind, okay? So the brown paint here, the wood here, all right? And if you don't have a completely accurate, perfect line, like I'm hitting the knots on the wood and it's making my pen kind of go wobbly, it's okay. We can fix it with a paintbrush. I just want to make sure that I get it fairly accurate so it comes out looking better later. Like I said, this is going to take you guys a few minutes to do. I'm going to put my paint over here so I don't put my elbow in it, which I've done many times. All right, so this is going to take a few minutes. Take your time. And this is work, it's a little different than most other paintings that we do together. Because the focal point of this painting, obviously, is the oak leaf and the Yukon symbol, right? So we want to make sure we get those as accurate as possible. So anywhere there's black ink, you outline it. So the acorn, you're going to leave a little line of white between the head of the acorn and the body of the acorn, okay? If the ink stopped in the printer and didn't put ink on a certain section, your pen is also going to stop, all right? So again, you're going to have an outline like a coloring book page when we're done here, to then take your time and paint inside of. Now, the cool thing is you can use white paint to paint this, or you can use blue. You can use any color you want, really. You can do gray if you're more of a contemporary style home. But the oak leaf can be black, white, gray, any color, really. And yes, your hand is going to get tired. Try hard to keep the stencil still. Sorry about the dog. So I'm just going to do the oak leaf on this one. I'll get to the Yukon later. You guys watching me trace is really not a fun evening. if it's easier for you guys to work on a table as opposed to on an easel, like I know it's easier for me to trace down as opposed to sitting up here, you can do that. You can also paint in any, you know, any way that's a little easier to you, okay? Like for example, if I do my Yukon over here. All right, I'll trace my Yukon. My OCD is kicking in. Like I said, it's interesting being in my head. Type A OCD and an art free-flowing artist. It's always never a dull moment around here. Anyway. Life is always entertaining. Especially in my studio. Okay. My paper didn't move. I think it did. What a cool idea for a graduate. Didn't even think of that. Keep hitting the wood grain and it's making my pen go wonky. That's all right. It's just chalk. We can wash it off later. No big deal. That's the beauty of this. Okay. Whew. Hands tired. All right. So here you have, hopefully you can see it. I think you can. There we go. Okay. So I traced the oak leaf. I traced the chalk. Okay. And now begins the task of painting it. So I like to use both the medium brush and the baby brush. Okay. So even if you're not done tracing right this second, stop for a minute and pay attention. Let's see here. I can't get the stencil to transfer. So I've traced the leaf and cut the veins and put painter's tape, and hopefully the absence of paint will make the pattern. Let's see here. So I traced the leaf. You've traced, oh, so you cut it all out first and then tried to do it? Is that what you're saying, Amy? Okay, yeah, so if you cut it out and then you can actually use a pencil. You cut it out, lay it down, and then use a pencil to trace around. So you'll have pencil on your wood to then paint inside of. I know it's like an extra step, but it'll be worth it at the end, okay? All right, so again, I want you guys to stop just for a second so I can give you a little bit of instruction, okay? So you're gonna wanna go back and forth between the baby brush and the mommy brush, or the medium one and the little one, all right? Depending on how small the area is. Now the oak leaf, definitely, you're gonna want the smaller one. In here, you can probably use, depending on the size of your brush that you bought or you have, play it by ear, the smaller the better, okay? You're gonna want white paint. There you are, here, okay? Just a little bit of white paint. And you're just going to try to paint in the direction of the wood grain, okay? So if I do the N, obviously going across the top, you can't, but you're literally, the rest, pretty much most of this class is going to be painting in the lines, okay? So, I'm gonna do it this way. I'm better at doing lines left to right than I am up to down. So I'm gonna do it this way. Now, if you have kind of wonky lines from the chalk is like all messed up or whatever. Once all of this paint is dry, we can wash it off just like you can wash off a chalkboard, okay? So don't worry about trying to make those wonky lines disappear with the paint. Okay. We can wash them off later. Right, so the angle of the end is kind of hard to go in the grain, the way the grain of the wood is. So just do your best. Now, a couple of things with this. And that's basically it, guys, okay? So I'm gonna just keep on going, coloring it in, essentially, with a small brush. If you want it to be more washed out, and you want it to be a little bit more weathered, you can add a little bit of water to your paint and it'll be more like stain, okay? And I'll show you what that looks like compared to straight up paint. All right, I'm gonna do so in the water a little bit, not a lot of water, not like we did the background, okay? If you want to have really heavy duty coat of paint, you can come back and do multiple layers of paint. All right, so there's lots of different looks that you can get with this. More weathered, which is a little bit of water, and sort of missing paint, right? Or brand new with a lot of paint. If you do it more weathered, you will see your brush strokes a little bit and it will look more imperfect. So my type A's, you're probably not gonna wanna do watered down, all right? So the first, where are we? This first line of the end, where am I? Oop, I'm backwards. We were just talking about this, Lauren, being mirror image and backwards and stuff. Okay, so this first line right here, I did with watered down paint. The diagonal, and then this final line, I did with straight up white paint, one coat. Okay, so you can kind of see the wood grain coming through the white with water. All right. Here, and I'll do, so three different things you can do here. Hang on, I'm gonna show you the difference between the three. You get to pick which one you want. Now, obviously, if you do a second coat of paint on your wood, it's gonna take you a little longer, right? So just be aware of that. And again, it doesn't all have to get done in one day either. You can always come back to it later. Okay, so. Left to right. First end, this first line of the N is white with water. The diagonal is one coat of white. The last vertical is two coats of white. That's the difference, okay? And as you can see, it's not 100% perfect, and that's fine too, okay? So take your time, go through, decide which one you like. Maybe you want to start off with the white with water. Do all of it first, see if you like it. If you don't, you can always paint another coat on top. So that would be how I would suggest you try it and start it. Okay, so whether you're doing canvas or you're doing wood, same thing. And you're welcome, Pat. I'm glad you're having fun. Either or, same concept. You got to paint within the lines. So take your time, go around. I'm going to do white with water to make it kind of a stain, right? I'm going to try that first, see if I like it. I probably will. It'll look more weathered and old. Beat up, right? If you like that sort of barn look. Now with the canvas, we are going to have to paint some distressed lines on top. And I'll show you that in a minute, all right? So let me just get white with water down here first. I'm just gonna do the Yukon for now. So I can jump over to the canvas and get that going too, okay? with water. There's so the you can see it much clearer there. This one here is white with water. The end of this one has straight white paint. Okay. And the amount of water will determine how bright the white is. You have more water, it's going to be less sharp white. It's going to be less white, right? So it's going to be more washed out. The more paint you have, the brighter the letters will be. Okay. Now, on the canvas, if you're doing canvas, I would suggest just using straight paint for now, rather than watered down paint, because we can distress it later. Like I said, I'm going to show you guys how to do that here in a minute. Let me just get this Yukon done. That one I had more. If you notice, I had more paint, less water. This one I had a lot of water, less paint. See, so it kind of faded out. So I'm gonna have to add another layer to that one later. Just something to think about with your water paint combination, how much of each you're using. Again, I'm just using my baby brush and I'm painting within the lines. But again, if you start off with water and white and it comes out really uneven, like mine is, it seems like, I can always come back and paint another coat later. It's also going to fade even more. For example, the water, see it's starting to fade here. It's because the wood is soaking up the water, all right? And it's soaking the paint in. So it's going to make it fade a little bit. So you're going to want to let it dry before you decide if you want to add a second coat. Apparently I need different glasses. I can't see that close up. All right. So same thing with the oak leaf. You're just gonna color inside the lines. Everywhere that the ink from your printer printed something is where you're gonna put white paint or whatever color you're doing, okay? All right, so I'm gonna let that dry a little bit because it's already starting to fade. I can see that the wood is really absorbing some of my paint. Here, like I said, I did two coats. So that's why it looks a lot brighter over here than it does over here. So I'll probably end up putting a second coat on it. But just wanted to kind of share that with you. All right, so while you guys are continuing that, where's my other canvas? There it is. I'm going to quickly get a coat here so that we can, I can show you how to do the finish details of streaking brown on top. I don't know if you guys can tell that. So I painted it all white first, right? I then came back with what we call a dry brush. I'll explain it in a second. But I took paint, a little bit of paint on a very dry brush and just kind of streaked over it to give those streaks to make it look more weathered. Okay, so that's how I did that with even the oak leaf. I streaked brown over it. Again, a very, very, very dry brush. And then the last steps, which we can do on both the canvas and also on the wood if you wanted to. We can make it look like wood planks. I can show you that here in a couple of minutes. Let me just see if I can get this going a little bit for you. While you guys continue painting in, coloring in your lines. I'm going to trace very quickly. So I can paint it in and show you how to streak over it. I really should shut that off. It keeps chiming at me. I'm sorry about that. Inside the lines. I'm just going to do a really quick paint job over here, so it's not going to be anything beautiful. That way I can catch up to you guys. I just want to be able to get this done so I can show you how to distress it and make it look like it's on wood. All right. Put some of the wood grain lines back on top. Again, I'm not doing the most perfect job over here, and that's okay. So once you have, I didn't even center it. That's funny. It's off center. That's right. Has Aaron done any other classes to paint UConn landmarks? Yes, actually, I have a few of them. I think Lauren or Emily can jump in here and let you guys know where to find those recordings. I think we're doing another one too, right, Emily?
Yeah, so we actually have, we can send out a link to our YouTube page, and that has two pre-recorded videos that Aaron has done, one of Avery Point and one of Horse Barn Hill. And we actually do have another paint night coming up on Saturday, June 5th. The picture is still to be determined, so stay tuned. We're going to be sending out a poll to have people actually choose the picture this time. So absolutely, but we can send all that information out.
Yes, Emily did send me all the pictures to let me figure out which one I want. I haven't answered you yet, Emily. Sorry.
Oh, that's fine.
I did see it coming. We have done a few, and looks like we're doing a few more. So stay tuned. That would be awesome to have you with us. Vanessa, the wrong side of the wood. Oh, no. You know, it might look okay. You might want to keep going with it to see how it turns out. I mean, it might just have more character being on the back side of the wood. You never know. And you do know how to do it, Vanessa. You can always redo it. And we're going to send out, of course, we're going to have the YouTube. This video is going to also be up on the YouTube channel, the UConn YouTube channel. So you can always replay it and redo it on the right side of the wood, if that's what you want to do. But I have a funny feeling that you'll make it work on the back side. All right. It might give it more character, more grit. Oh, I can't wait to see it, but that's cute. All right. So if you're on a canvas, like I said, like what I did here, and you want to make it look more like this, which is more distressed. Okay. What you do is add another layer of brown paint with the paintbrush. Okay. So I'm going to go back to that bigger brush. Once I have all of this painted, okay, the white of the oak leaf, the white of the UConn symbol, right, the logo, I'm going to take my brush, wash it, dry it, and then I'm going to grab, remember I said dry brush technique? It literally is a dry brush. So make sure your brush is really dried off, really good. And I go grab a little bit of paint. You don't need a lot, okay? Literally just a little bit of paint. And you can see there's no chunks of paint. It's really dry, there's not a lot. And you're literally going to go in the direction of the grain of wood. And you're basically just leaving sort of a haze or a remnant of the paint on top of, I'm just going to do the first three letters here. And if you wanted to do the whole thing and make it even darker like this, you can. Okay. This I put on another layer completely of all of this. You can go back over and just do another coat. You can add a little bit of black into it if you wanted it to be darker like this one. I think that's what I did now that I'm looking at it. All right. So if you wanted to add
Aaron?
Yeah.
Do you have suggestions to seal? So if they're making a tray that will then be used for food?
Yeah. So definitely polyurethane. You're going to want to go to Home Depot and sometimes you can spray it. Sometimes you might have to use a sponge brush. Double check the labels to make sure that they're food safe, okay? If they're not food safe, you're gonna want to get a piece of glass that fits the size of the bottom of the tray. Glass is food safe, okay? So to seal the wood, like I said, like a polyurethane, or there's gonna give you a spray polyurethane or a painted one. But then if you're going to have food on it, definitely put a piece of glass down on top, and then the food won't pick up any of the poly or paint or anything else that's on the wood. Okay. hopefully it's a standard size, but you can go to a glass manufacturer if it's not and have them cut a piece of glass to size. And it's actually not that expensive if you wanted to do that too. Hopefully that helps you. Yeah, I would definitely use glass. Okay. Glass for food, if you wanted it for food. If you want it for other, like to put raw food down on it. But if you're going to have a plate of food down on the tray, then polyurethane is fine. But if you're going to serve food like cheese, use it as a cheese plate, I would definitely use, put it on glass. Okay, so that's how you're going to distress your letters. I distressed only the first three. I might even go back and do some more. Okay. Again, it's just that dry brush paint over the top. And you can do it on this as well if you wanted to distress this, okay? Too much paint, not enough water. Look at that, I went and did a boo-boo. There we go, water, 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 water. There we go. So that's how, if you had a mistake like what I just did, I don't know if you guys saw that, I put too much paint down. I literally went right at it with brown paint. The way to combat that is to put water it down. There you go. So that's how you're going to distress this, same way. Okay, watered down brown paint. Okay, it's another coat of paint coming up over your white. Okay. You have watered down whites and now you have watered down brown kind of streaking on top of it. It'll push the paint back in and make it look less brand spanking new, if that makes any sense. This will also tone down the white paint that I had over here. Remember, I had straight white paint. I think I'm on the wrong side of the wood too there. Vanessa, I think I'm on the wrong side. I can see the lines going this way of how they planed it. That's funny. So just add a little bit more water to it to kind of push the paint down and in. So it's not sitting on top as much. And again, really, really, really long brush strokes. I'll push your Yukon letters kind of back and recede them a little bit because we just put another sort of a coat, streaky coat of brown, thin brown paint over it. Just makes it look a little bit more distressed and a little more used or old or, you know, that weathered look. Okay. How are we doing, you guys? You're probably still coloring in your... So if we were using a blue background, would you use blue paint to distress the letters? Yes. So whatever this color is here is what you would use across it. Yes. Good question, Eleanor. So Lauren and Emily, you can tell me if anybody texts or asks a question because I'm not looking at the camera, okay?
You got it.
All right. So I like to outline one little section at a time. That's just typically how I paint. There's no wrong way to do this. So that's what I'm gonna do, is go around one little bit of white at a time. You guys can see. This is where the in-person classes differ greatly from the Zoom classes, because this is where everyone's talking and painting and socializing. It's hard to socialize on here. But that's okay. Make do with what we have, right? Here's the other bit. Okay. There is no other bit. Couldn't really see my chalk lines. I had to refer back to my paper, my original stencil. I usually don't hang my paintings in my house, these kinds of paintings. I have so many of them, well over 100, so I really can't even hang them in my house. I usually have one that's hanging at any given time, but because I have so many, I can't. I rotate that one usually, but this one I might keep up. I like more than just for a couple of weeks, you know. I kind of like this one. Good idea, Emily. Even my professional paintings, like the one in the back wall, I don't typically keep them on my wall for very long because I rotate them. Every time I paint a new one, I want to live with it for a while. So, but this might, like I said, this one might be one that stays up for a while. Part of the regular decor of the house. Hopefully you guys are doing good. Anybody have any questions? Hopefully you guys can see what you're doing. Mm-hmm. They're all quiet. I mean, I guess that means they're busy painting, right? So the last few steps are actually pretty easy, easy to remember also. So I think that if we do go ahead right now, it won't be that much of a problem for those that are not done, but you're gonna wanna just pay attention a little bit, all right? So you have your white painted and it's bright white and it's sitting on top. And if you like it that way, cool, leave it. If you want to make it look more distressed, like this is here, this is where you're going to paint over another coat of brown like we did on the back. It's the same thing. Wet, watered down brown paint on top of this, and it'll make it look more distressed and old like this. If you're on canvas and you want to make it look distressed, you add more brown paint, but this time it's not watered down over here, okay? So do exactly what we did in the background on top, okay? So that's why it's pretty easy for you guys because you've already done it once. You're gonna just do it again. So I'm gonna make a really watered down, hopefully you guys can see, okay, there you go. Really watered down stain, right? And you're just gonna go over what you did, really streaky. I'm trying not to go over my Yukon, I'll lose it again. And I don't wanna do two coats of brown over it, but that's what will happen when you do just another coat of watered down brown on top, okay? And you can leave it just like that if you like it. Leave it. Hardest part is to know when to stop, okay? Hardest part of anything. Now, if you want to make it look like planks of wood, three planks, that's what this one is. It looks like three different planks of wood, okay? You're going to want to measure three equal. This is what, 11 divided by 3 is what, 2.5 maybe? 3, 3, 6, 9. See, I'm horrible at math. So now 3¾, 3½, 3½, right? So let's mark 3½. So I'm gonna mark at the top. Not 3¾. My bad. Okay, so, and then you mark it again at the bottom. Depends on how big your wood or canvas is, okay? So measure, mark, and then you're going to, with pencil, draw a line connecting the two so that we can paint a line here in a minute. So there's, where is it? Can you see it? Lines that I drew, pencil lines, two pencil lines that I drew right through it, okay? Just. All right, so now what you're gonna do baby brush, black paint, and you're going to literally draw a line, paint a line right down the middle with black paint. Or you can even do straight up brown paint. Let's just see what it looks like with straight up brown. Hang on. That one over here, I did black. That's black here, but I'm going to try brown over here. So there, you're just going to paint a line right down the whole thing because it's supposed to be the space between the two. Now, this is a dark brown black. I just had it mixed on my hands here, on my paintbrush. And by doing this, it gives the illusion. And this you're also going to want to paint right across here too. All right, I didn't paint the top and the bottom like I asked you guys to, but you're going to want to go across the top, down the front, down the bottom, okay? With that line. Again, I'm using a brown black color. You can use straight brown, you can use straight black. The one I did on the canvas, like I said, is straight black. I find it's much easier for me to draw lines if I go from left to right. So I always want to hold my canvas or my wood or whatever it is I'm doing. So I can go left to right. So that's always a trick. Okay. So again, after you paint the white, you're going to distress it by streaking over brown, right? In this case, it's brown with water. In this case, it's just brown paint on a dry brush. Okay, this is the canvas. Then you're going to measure your planks, your wood planks. If you want to do planks, you don't have to. Okay. You want to make it look like three different planks. You're going to measure out and then drop a line with either a dark brown or a black. Okay. Pretty simple. Literally goes right on top of everything that you just painted. Okay, that way it looks like a space between planks. Okay. And then the absolute last step, if you want to, and again, you don't have to do this either, is to add what looks like nails. Now, because this is wood, you can actually add real nails to it. You don't have to paint the nails in. Or if you wanted to paint them, you could, okay? So what I did here is I painted a little circle of black, and then I'll show you how I made it look like it's rusted or shadows, all right? So. Little black circle. And I'm going to try to be straight across with my nails like they would if it were a fence. And try to be consistent on the size of my nail head. Like if you look, this one's too big compared to this one. So I'm going to make this one a little bigger. Go. The more consistent you are, the more realistic it'll look. Okay. Your little nail holes or nails, right? And now to make it look like it's rusty, right? The little drips of rust that come down from the nail. Grab a little bit of brown paint. I'm using the medium brush for this, okay? And I'm literally just gonna flick down. You notice it's literally just a flick, okay? Little bit of paint, flick down from the black. And it could be the black is a little bit wet too, that's okay. So it makes it look like it's crying, right? Sort of. Literally just a flick. And from far away, it looks either like a shadow or like it's rusted and drippy rust. And the absolute last little step is putting a little bit of a white curve at the top. See the little tiny white, little bit of white, right? Little bit of white. So it's like a comma on the top, right? Or like a little eyebrow. There we go. A little more like an eyebrow shape at the top of all of your nails. Little tiny baby brush. Literally just a little bit, very, 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 very thin. Your paintbrush almost does not touch your wood, okay? Almost not touching at all. So you can do it this way, so you guys can see that. Little, very little. Okay. And then that's it, you guys. I want to finish this, come back in and finish this and add some more streaks to it. But that's it. You do the same thing on the canvas if you wanted to do it on the canvas too.